We already have discussed the concept of cyclic barrier in the previous video of this session. But there I forgot to discuss one important point, that what is the cyclic in the cyclic barrier? What makes a barrier cyclic? Because we know that there is a barrier where all the threads wait for each other to continue their further execution together. But what is cyclic about it? We already have seen this code in the previous video of this session. We are creating 5 new threads and we are passing the reference of type cyclic barrier, which takes 6 threads to trip, and we are passing the reference variable of type reentrant lock. The names of the threads will be T0 to T4. After that, we are starting all the 5 threads. Then after, the thread main has also to wait on the barrier. Here in the method run of all the 5 threads, we are having a lock and unlock. In between the lock and unlock, the threads are sleeping for 500 milliseconds. After that, all the 5 threads have to wait at the barrier. So if less than 6 threads have called b.await, means if less than 6 threads are waiting at the barrier, then they have to wait until all the 6 threads arrive at this point. And when all the 6 threads have called b.await, then only these 6 threads may proceed further together. Let's execute this code practically, and then we will change something in the code to see what is cyclic in it. Open createThread.java, and this is the same code as we have seen. Open myThread.java, and this is the same code as we have seen. Try to compile these two codes, Java C, createThread.java, and myThread.java. Compiles fine. Now run it. Java createThread. It runs fine. And you can see all the threads finished together. All the 6 threads have finished together. Now let's open the createThread.java. And I do not want the method main to wait at the barrier. So remove this await method from the thread main. I do not want the thread main to wait at the barrier. Since now the thread main will not wait at the barrier, so the barrier should be tripped, should be break after 5 threads have been arrived at the barrier. So right here 5, because now the barrier will be tripped after arrival of the 5 threads. Now open mythread.java, and just put everything in between a infinite while loop. While true. Give opening and closing curly brackets for the while. Now what will happen here? When the 5 threads arrive at the barrier, then the barrier will be tripped. But after the barrier gets tripped, the barrier will be recreated once again. And again the 5 threads can come to the same barrier. So because of this cyclic recreation nature of the barrier, we call it a cyclic barrier. Because after getting tripped, after getting broken, the barrier gets recreated once again. Try to compile this code. Java C, createThread.java, myThread.java. Compiles fine. Now run it. Java, createThread. And you can see all the threads are printing together. Of course, main is not printing together, but all the threads are printing together. And they are printing in a cycle. When they start a new cycle, they find an untripped barrier, an unbroken barrier. So every time the barrier gets broken, the barrier gets tripped, it recreates itself. That's why the barrier is called cyclic barrier. But what happens with the countdown latch? Let's apply the same while loop on the countdown latch. Countdown barrier is not cyclic. Let's open createThread.java. And as you can see, here we are using the countdown latch. The thread main is waiting for the value of count to become 0. And who is doing the value of count 0 is the 5 threads created by the thread main. Let's open mythread.java. We also have a detailed study about countdown latch. The link of that video is given in the video description and I button. So here you can see all the 5 threads are decreasing the value of count to 0. Let's compile this code. Java C, create thread.java and mythread.java. Compiles fine, now run it. Java, create thread. It runs fine and printing the expected output. But let's do the same thing. Let's put a while loop in the run method. While with true. Right here, while true. While true. Give a opening curly bracket. Give a closing curly bracket. Now try to compile this code. What will happen here is, for the first loop, the count will become 0. Then the count cannot be restored to 5. And since the thread main was waiting for the value of count to become 0, so the thread main already has finished its execution because the count value reduced to 0 in the very first loop. From the next loop onwards, the value of count will be printed as 0. So there is no cyclic nature in the countdown latch, but there is a cyclic nature in the cyclic barrier, as you have seen. Let me compile and execute this code. Java C, create thread.java and mythread.java, compiles fine, now run it. It executes fine and you see the nature of the output. Now it will keep on printing the value of count at 0. Because all the threads are running together, they are printing the value of count. And a random output you can see here. So hopefully you got all my points and you know that why the cyclic barrier is cyclic. That's all for this video, guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe my channel on YouTube. Like my page on Facebook. And leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.